options.com. And we're going to see this week if the market recovers from what I predicted last week would happen, was that sell on the news on the quote-unquote good jobs numbers. Folks, whenever you have a market up 3-4 days in a row prior to a non-farm payrolls, it's almost like shooting fish in a barrel that the market's going to sell on the news. And it did pretty heavily on Friday, as we saw the, you know, the Dow triple digits down, the VIX popping back up to 14, what I call the new resting heart rate for the VIX, so to speak. So it's going to be a very interesting week. We're relatively light domestically here on our macroeconomic data, but we're going to get some information out of Japan and China Monday and Tuesday that could potentially move our markets. We'll get consumer credit on Monday, not a huge market moving number there, but we are going to see a monetary policy statement out of Japan. We're going to see some data out of China. We're going to get the unemployment rate out of China and retail sales numbers as well. If Japan and China sneeze, we're going to catch a cold. Okay, we're going to have some Fed lieutenants run around speaking throughout the week. It might not impact the market that much. But new loans and money supply out of China Wednesday morning, and it goes for a couple days. We'll see this data string out there. Definitely market-moving information, in my opinion. Wholesale inventories here in the States. We'll have a bond auction. We'll also get the minutes released from the most previous Fed meeting, where we can see the written words and see whether or not they match up with the spoken words. Sometimes they are a little bit different, and there's some nuances in those FOMC statements there. Some core machinery orders and bank lending out of Japan, and then the trade balance number out of China Thursday morning will definitely it'll move their markets. And as I said, any tsunami that starts in China ends up reaching our shores as well. We'll take a look at our federal budget balance. Don't even get me started about that. CPI and PPI out of China. Definitely market moving information, like I said, but we'll get our own inflation data on Friday with PPI and core PPI and University of Michigan consumer sentiment. That's probably going to be the biggest market mover domestically here in the States, is the University of Michigan consumer sentiment, the preliminary one. So a lot of interesting stuff going on. Read a good report over the weekend. I talked about a lot of China economic data coming out, but BBVA came out with the world's most powerful nation type of thing, world market power index. They take a lot of factors into account. Is it the United States? Of course it isn't. It's the country that I predicted would overtake the United States by 2016 as the world's economic superpower, and it's kind of taken over the United States right around now with their world market power index, which takes a lot of things into account. I'm not going to get into it, just kind of proving my long-term bullish position on China. Short-term bearish, right? We have a lot of long call diagonals and synthetic stock on China via the FXI. Short-term, they got a lot of warts, folks. Credit, real estate, a lot of issues. But as I said, the PBOC, People's Bank of China, and dudes with bayonets can do whatever the hell they want in that country to make sure they don't have a Lehman Brothers or a Bear Stearns moment. So very interesting. We'll see if the SPX can hold above its 50-day moving average, which is around 1838. We had a pretty serious pullback on Friday, but you know, take a look at that chart, folks. It goes up, and it goes up on quantitative easing and Janet Yellen saying everybody's going to get a trophy. So that's where we are, folks. If you're interested in a managed account, obviously here at Topkin Options or Wealth Creation Investing, we like teaching people how to fish. Okay, if you want to sit on the dock and have a professional fish for you, so to speak, and manage as part of a diversified portfolio, potentially manage some of your assets, shoot us an email. managedaccounts@topkinoptions.com. We have a strategic partnership with an RIA, a registered investment advisor up in Illinois, called the Black Bay Group. Minimum investment for a managed account is $30,000, and we launched a hedge fund on April 1st, and I am the chief development officer of Black Bay Fund Management, the hedge fund we just launched. It's the same blended strategy that the RIA has used for the past 4 years to blow away the S&P 500 and perform 141% in the past 4 years. Do the math, it's about a 22.5-23% average return. Folks, That's some shit hot performance, in my opinion. You have to be an accredited investor. If you don't know what that is, you're probably not. You can look that up. It's $1 million in net worth, excluding your primary residence, and $250,000 a year as a couple, or $200,000 as an individual. And the minimum investment for the Black Bay hedge fund is $250,000. But if you're interested in the trading the same strategy as a hedge fund, you can do it via the RIA. And the minimum investment there, as I said, is $30,000. You can get all the information that you need on this page right here, topgunoptions.com/interested-in-managed-accounts. Interested in managed accounts with a bunch of dashes in there. Okay. Or you can just go to the Top Gun Options homepage and click on the banner at the top, and you can see the charts. If you see this new to options banner, just click the refresh button and voila. The managed accounts banner is going to come up because we kind of rotate our banners up here. Okay, so there it is. All right, folks, I got to run. I'll be back over at TopGunOptions.com Tuesday through Thursday to do my daily market sit rep. Make sure you're checking that out. And more importantly, folks, make sure you're also sharing it. Tweet it out to your folks, your followers. Share it on Facebook. Share it on LinkedIn. Help us spread the word about the good work that we do at Top Gun Options. Okay, have a great week. Happy hunting. Make sure you hedge. And I'll be talking over at TGO tomorrow. We'll see you.